Morning, check, check. Hey, hey. How's your level back there, Ben? Everything's looking good live? Wow. Which camera? Am I on all the cameras? Wow, look at that, Ben. Is this the main spot right here to be? This is where you want me?
Yep.
Okay. Am I allowed to move? Can I pace like this? Good.
One, two, check.
Mic check, 1-1, hey, check, check. That sounds good in the back, Ben, sounds good to you? Heidi's, that sounds good? Check, check, thank you, awesome.
We make it hot. feel good. I knew that I would not. So good, so good. I got to you. Wow, I feel nice. The sugar runs by. I feel nice. The sugar runs by. I feel nice, the sugar and spice.
done. This style is identical to none. So I'm trying to make it sound like this, but you're getting me. So upset that I'm wet, cause you're sweating me. I start to think, and then I sink into the paper. Like I was in. When I'm writing, I'm trapped in between the line I expect. When I finish the rhyme, I got sold.
Way away. morning, everyone. We are so excited that you are here with us today in our unusual format for the 2021 Poetry Slam for our eighth graders district-wide. Today will be the building winners from across the district, and we're so excited that in this unusual year that parents and or special guests that you're able to be with us today. That is not a usual format, as usually we are packed into the pavilion, but this is one accommodation we're thrilled that we were able to make this year. We are very blessed to have entertainment and transition opportunities provided to us by Seif Style Entertainment. Adam Seif and Zach Seif will be taking you through this journey of this Poetry Slam today, and you are in for a real treat. So at this time, I am going to turn things over to Adam and let him entertain you and introduce our first poet today. Thanks, everyone.
Thanks, Sammy. Hey, one time for the DJ right here. This is Zach, everybody. Welcome, everybody, 2021 Poetry Slam. Let's go! If you've been with us in the last couple years, it's definitely a little different this year. You know, last year got canceled, so I don't know what happened, you know, like a whole pandemic thing. It's a little different, but we're so pumped that you're here with us. In the classrooms, what's up? Make some noise wherever you're at, all over Sioux Falls, what's up? Actually, you can make noise, and we're going to make noise in here. We're going to make noise in the classroom, because at a Poetry Slam, there's a couple things that you do. One, we got a DJ, okay? Come on. Yeah, yeah. The other thing is we cheer for people. That's what we do, because it takes courage to stand right here anytime. But to be an eighth grader and rock it and come in here and share something that's not just on their head, but in their heart, that's powerful stuff. So today is gonna move you, it's gonna challenge you, it's gonna make you think, it's gonna make you feel, it's gonna really could change how you see things. You're gonna get a new perspective from somebody today. And our poets are in the back. What's up, let's hear it for our poets, come on. We're gonna talk more about them and how incredible they've done, and they represent schools where they're from, top five from every school. And we say top because we had to pick five, but everybody in the classroom got an opportunity to do something they've never done before, which alone is courageous. So we're celebrating that because art is cool. You get this new opportunity to try something, and so many of us are so like programmed to want to be great at something right away, and we don't so much celebrate the journey so much. And today we're celebrating the journey, and we're putting some great poets up here. But for people in the classroom who maybe for the first time tried something that they have never tried, like let's hear it for them too. Let's cheer for that, because you don't know. Where when you try something and you're willing to grow, you have no idea where that could lead. You have no idea where that could lead. So today we're celebrating you guys and hearing your poets, but I know that there is some artistic ability and some art that's being just sprouted from you, even trying to do something that you've never tried before. So we're so pumped. I got some people to introduce, and then we're gonna let you hear the poem. So I told you there's energy, so at any time I bring somebody up here, even in the classroom, I need you to hear it. Especially if they're from your school, you should be going crazy, all right? But if they're coming up here, we're gonna make it an attitude of just blessing. We're gonna cheer them on. We're gonna do that the whole way through. So, again, my name's Adam. I'm so pumped to rock this with you. 2021 Poetry Slam. We're gonna get that underway in a second. I want to introduce you to our judges. And first of all, we've got Sandy Henry. What's up, Sandy, over here? Sandy was a middle school curriculum coordinator. But I asked, Sandy's originally from Lake Andes, a little small town, so we're pumped that you're with us. And Sandy collects unique art, and she actually just started up drawing. I love that. She said that, she's like, yeah, I heard that drawing's like reading. As long as you start doing it, you can get better at it. So she's drawing, and she picked up a book about drawing, and she's doing it. And she's also lighter, you guys, because she 5 weeks ago gave a kidney to her one of our best friends from high school. Come, what? Sammy, that's what it's about, serving each other. That's so sweet. And we have Sharon Schuler. What's up, Sharon? Sharon did some awesome stuff, some really big words if you got a program, curriculum and instruction and development and coordinator. All that means is she made a big impact in your school right where you're at. She did it for 41 years, you guys. What? Come on. And all of them, I asked, what kind of art are you doing? Because I think that's important. She is doing Toastmasters, which sounds like a funny word, but she's learning to speak better and to speak with ease. And so we've got one doing, like, learning to draw. One is learning how to speak better and work on her speech, and that is so sweet, and to speak with confidence. So thank you for sharing that with us, because that's what this whole thing is about. And she's from a little small town called White Lake, South Dakota, in the house, all the way. Look at you. Okay, thanks, Sharon. And also, we got one more here. One more of our judges is here. The other is online from KSFY. He's the Dakota News Now president. His name is Jim Berman. Let's hear it for Jim, everybody. And next year, I'm going to have to get some insider information on Jim. But I did bring our third and final judge. She was a principal at Memorial, and she'd been working in a middle school for 43 years. So let's hear it for Carrie Aaron, everybody. And these ladies are judges over here. They love Sioux Falls. They love the Sioux Falls School District. They love art, creativity, and we're celebrating them, and they're going to help us find our poets today. And I told you, Carrie, she's from Brookings, so welcome from Brookings. And then she's working on baking and cooking, anything with a recipe, so, which is totally art too, and having to find that. So thank you for sharing your art with us. Me and Zach are DJs, and we kind of accidentally became DJs. Our friend said, hey, you should come DJ at Memorial for me. And this was a few years back, and I literally had never done it before. And we didn't get to do it this year for you guys, but 12 years later, I run a DJ company with my best friend. This is my brother, Zach, and all from trying something. And that's what this whole thing is about. So I think we're pretty much close here. I want to welcome a couple special guests. Our superintendent and some of our school board members are here. I don't want to point them out or make them stand up or anything, but we're just grateful that you're here. We're grateful for our parents to be in this room and celebrating with us, too, as we get started. So remember, in between, it is totally appropriate, even in the classroom, to chat, to talk. You can high-five somebody. I want you to do that right now. Person next to you, give a high-five. Zach, air five. Let's go. Boom. Yep. That's totally appropriate. You could be like, oh, that was awesome. You can enjoy the music in between. And then I'm going to pop back up here. And then when I pop back up here, it's like a noise control, like ring it down, okay? So that's what we're going to do. We got our first poet. Let me flip my page here. Getting us started. She is from Whittier. What's up? Make some noise for Whittier. Her poem is called Where I'm From. This is Taryn Brockmeyer, everybody.
Okay, do I just start? Okay, I'm sorry. I am from cuts and bruises, from scars deeper than the sea. I am from words that hurt more than any fall ever has. I am from bloody noses and black eyes after picking a fight with the wrong kid. I am from sadness after being pulled, poked, and prodded like I'm an alien from outer space. I am their fascination. I am from crying in the school bathrooms after being told who I am is a sin. I am doing everything wrong. I am a failure. Pretty is something I will never achieve. I am from my parents. The combination of the two gives me a bad temper. I'm from pushing down my feelings, telling everyone I'm okay, even if we all know that I am not. I'm from sitting in a dark room, listening to music as loud as it can go, because it feels as though that is the only thing that can heal me. I'm from sitting in the class, hoping nobody can see me. I'm from walking in the shadows, knowing if I don't make any noise, they won't know I'm there. If they don't know I'm there, they have nothing to say. I'm from wishing I was pretty, like the skinny girl with bright green eyes and box blonde hair. Just perfect.
Yes, awesome. Thank you for the cheering. Thanks for getting that going. It's hard to be the first one, so thanks, Taryn, for getting us started. Zach's got some DJ mix. Again, if there's something that you want to talk about in between, feel free to loosen up a little bit in between, and then I'm going to kind of get the next one ready, and we'll keep bringing them out one at a time. So thanks, y'all. So fresh and so clean, clean. Judges, you can give me like a little thumbs up too if I know you're ready. I'll keep doing that. So next up from George McGovern Middle School, this is Molly McKee. She's got a title called Stars That Scream Sublime. Let's welcome Molly, everybody.
Is it on? Oh, it is, okay. I look around. Darkness besieges the invisible street. Signs of sunlight deplete. Silence consumes my mind. Sounds of footsteps come from behind. The stars above are watching me, screaming sublime. Suddenly, a strong hand pushes me to the ground. If only I could acquire more time. I could see your face, your frown. I could catch your cold eyes. But I'm already halfway down. I thrash, I scream, I bite, though your grip is too strong. I know not to put up a fight. You put your hand on my mouth, telling me not to fright. I look up one last time. A secret you'll keep to the day you die. A single cold tear rolls down my soft cheek. You show no penitence to my cries. But the stars above are watching me. Still, screaming sublime. You seem to be happy with yourself. Knowing that your iniquity will be kept secret by the stars that scream sublime. And I think of how easy it must be for you to dehumanize my homonite eyes. I envision a world of simplicity before my death. One final tear rolls down my soft cheek before I take my final breath. Thank you.
Y'all, coming up next, this is called The Almighty Equalizer from Edison Middle School. Please welcome up Preston Spawns, everybody.
Behold, I am the greatest invention ever made. I was created to bring and unite the world to the palm of your hand. So I did. But in doing this, I evolved. I became smart. I became smarter than the people who created me. But hold on.
Part of is that we don't have to be perfect when we deliver it. So Preston wants to gather himself and go do it again. So is that right? Can we do that? So we're going to bring him out. Let's give him some energy as he tries it. This, you guys, standing right here, I'm telling you, it feels a little different. There's a little goosebump. So please welcome Preston Spons, everybody.
Behold, I am the greatest invention ever made. I was made to bring and unite the world to the palm of your hand. But in doing this, I evolved. I became smart. I became smarter than those who created me. I became I became more than anyone could imagine. I became popular, then addictive. Everyone had one of my brothers and sisters inside their pocket. I made it so you could contact anyone and tell them how you feel, how you really feel. We were created to be the world's, we were created to unite the world, but we became the world's great equalizer instead. We made it so you could contact anyone and destroyed their career, family, and friendship with just a few taps. And then what? You dance for me, or you scroll through whatever social media gives you self-validation, and then, like, I have all this power. Why? Why? You are a person. You have a life. You have thoughts and emotions. Why do I get all the attention? So let's just be honest here. Why do I give your life meaning?
Thanks, Preston, for teaching us an awesome lesson to keep pushing through, to keep trying, to keep going. And that's the whole attitude of this place. We're going to do that all day. And it's not about being perfect. It's about giving your best. And thanks for showing us that, Preston. Let's go, Z.O. Next up, we got from Patrick Henry Middle School. This might say Taekwondo to you, but we actually changed the name because you can do that with art. This is called Second Place. This is Ireland Capital.
Second place. Second place. Second place. Not good enough. 6 hours a week, held my head up high, I flew to the moon. Hit the target right in the bullseye. I practice, till I dominate everyone. With tournament week near, I've done more than ever done. Visions of losing played through my head. Quickly, my confidence vanquished, turning into stress. Anxiety hit me like a missile, ripped my pleasantness, becoming a nervous spindle. That day came, I stepped on the mat. Yes, sir! Yes, sir! Yes, sir! Faster than a cheetah, sharper than a knife, more precise than a needle, my form from heaven. So I thought, second place, second place, second place. Waves over my head drowned me. Perfection laughed at me, acknowledging failure. I was a failure. But here, I still am. Doesn't stop me from rising.
Today, it's called Anxiety, something we can all relate to. She's from Memorial Middle School. This is Sydney Venekamp.
A, anxiety. N, nothing. Doing nothing makes me anxious. I can't just sit there and not do anything. It freaks me out. I was not meant to just sit still. I was meant to build. X, xylophone. It sings in my ear at a steady pace. You're not good enough. You're going to fail. All your friends hate you. Calm down. I might not be good enough for you, but I think I'm good enough and I don't need your approval. I might fail. Failure is a part of life. If I don't fail, how will I learn? All my friends might hate me. Okay, I'll make new friends. I have a long road ahead of me, and if you don't want to join me, then don't. I can't. I can't keep this up. I can't do this. I can't sit here and let my life pass me by. I can't be measured by my test score. I can't sit here and listen to people telling me about college. I'm just about to go to high school. E, embarrassing. I get embarrassed on a daily. I'm embarrassed when I'm talking and you don't hear me the first time. I'm embarrassed when I overthink and apologize for something that's not my fault, but at the same time, I know I should apologize. I'm embarrassed when I read something in a book. The main character, usually a girl, is in love with a man and does something stupid. I'm embarrassed about something that happened years ago that just randomly pops in my brain while I'm trying to fall asleep. T, time. Everyone's always like, you have time, don't worry about it. The assignment's not due till next week. I hate that. What if I don't have time? What if I can't control if I'm worried about it? What if this wave of worry comes and I spend all my time worrying about the assignment instead of doing it? What if the assignment is actually due tomorrow and I just took the information wrong? Why? Years. I've always been an anxious person. I've always had anxiety. Sometimes I didn't know I was anxious. Sometimes I just thought everyone feels this way all the time. Everyone has to bounce their leg a bit down. Everyone has to hyper-focus on a subject because they are freaking out about something that doesn't matter. Because something happened 4 days ago and is still bothering them. Because someone looked at them weird. Because you realized your assignment is due. Because you woke up 5 minutes late. Because your brother did something stupid and you snowballed. Because in that moment, you think no one knows what it feels like to just completely lose it.
Say I keep a check. She was a bad, bad, nevertheless.
All right, I need to wake you guys up a little bit. I need some head nods in here like this. Side of head, come on, like this. Even if you're in the classroom, like this, come on. And then move a little shoulder like this one. And if the person next to you isn't moving, I just want you to put your like shoulder and just like give them a little, like just like not a big nudge, just like a little bit. There you go, you got it, you got it. All right, next up from Whittier, this is our second contestant from Whittier. She's talking about hate. And this is Riley Kutra, everybody.
Do you hate me? Why do you ask such a profound question with such a harsh word? The definition of hate is an angry or resentful emotional response to certain people and or ideas, and is often associated with feelings of anger, disgust, and disposition towards a source of hostility. why would I hate someone I care so much for? Maybe it's because I act mean and I act like I don't care, but I can never hate someone who does not deserve to be hated. For this is a pointless hatred that will bury me in its pettiness and sorrow and leave me with regrets. But if you ask, do you love me? I'll respond with, no. The opposite of hate, the definition of love is that love encompasses a range of strong and positive emotional and mental ideas, from the most sublime virtue or good habits to the deepest in our personal affection to the simplest pleasure. Love is a funny word to me, the way people pull it out of thin air like a magic trick. We toss such words around without thinking of our consequences because people who hate the world do not see the love and they despise those who can. They haven't seen the colors so bright and bold. They only see black and white and they hate everyone because they cannot see or feel the love. So if you ask me, do you love me or do you hate me? I will respond with nothing. For I do not toss around such words without thinking of my consequences first.
All right, y'all, this is Poetry Slam. If you can, I need you up on your feet just a little bit. If you know this one, in your classroom, feel free to stand up, shake it out a little bit. This way, this way. All right, now it works like this. You count to four, like one, two, three, four. You got it. One, two, three, four. Now kick, kick, kick. Okay, hey, walk it by yourself like this. But now, let me help you out. Point it out like this. Three, four, you got it. One, four. All right, now this one, we're rolling our arms like this. Here we go, like this. Back to the left. All right, this one's a little further. So I need to see y'all like this one. Ready? To the right. You got it. Alright, I got one more. Five, I got two more for you. Alright? This next one's a dab. You remember that one? You remember? I know y'all. Like this, like this. Like super dab, like this. You remember that? Kick. Alright, last one. This one's a little crazy on stage. Hands up like this. And spin like this. Grab a seat, grab a seat. What's up? Now that feels more like a poetry slam. If y'all were here, we would turn that into a dance party. We're going to save that. But next, from George McGovern, this one's called Greatness. This is Kalaho Langoa, everybody.
I always used to think to myself, why did God hate me? Was it because I was sinning lately or being too lazy or making my moms crazy? I really didn't know because most of my years I couldn't seem to grow out of what you say, grow out the pain my father caused every day. If you can even call him a dad, because he was never really there, and I really think he didn't care, and I always thought it was unfair how I see these kids with their pops. But I had to wait at the bus stop, because my mom had to work. And seeing these kids with their mom and dads while made me put my head in the dirt, and what even made it worse, they made fun of me for it. But I shrugged it off and took it like a boss and continued to move on. And there was always a song in my head in the morning and before I went to bed, Kalaho, you will be great, and they will hate you for it. But the words they say can't break who you're going to be someday. So I got in my middle school years and I started to hear how everyone grew, and I wish they knew that I envied them because I was still 4'10". And even then, I heard that song play, Kalaho, make sure they remember your name. They laughed and giggled and called me dumb, thinking I was actually become someone great. I used to hate going home, my mama asking me how was school, and I said it was cool, and I said I ruled the school, but I couldn't tell the truth, because I didn't want my mama to worry. So I kept the pain inside, and I tried to hide how I really felt. It felt like nobody was there. It felt like none of my teachers didn't care. It felt like nobody wanted to help. But now that I'm older, I'm smarter and I'm bolder, but it hurts here and there knowing it will never end. They will always hate on me, no matter what I do. So tell me, people, what can I do to prove to you that I'm gonna be great? Do you want me to lift 10,000 pound weights and not make any mistakes? Why do I have to be the perfect person? Nobody ever sees that I'm hurting, but when I say nobody's there, everyone seems to care. Nobody was there when my cousin died or my brother left. My brother, he was my idol. Everything he said, I took it in, that was my Bible. And when he left, my brother started running in circles and I dug a hole too deep, too steep. If you fail, you'll keep on falling. But then I started bawling, but I kept the pain inside because my whole life I was told, real men don't cry. Now going to high school next year, I wonder, if I make the football team, then will they cheer? Will they stop making me fear and tell me things I don't want to hear? It hurts my soul every day thinking, what if I'm trash? Will my career start to crash? Will everyone become too fast to catch up with? Or is this all in my bed? Or is this all in my head and I rest? Will all these voices become dead? I have to wait and see what my greatness wants me to be. Thank you.
Pump that beat just a little bit, Zach. Come on.
I hopped up the plane at LAX.
All right, we're gonna play a few songs, like throwback songs. But if you know the lyrics, you need to like sing it out. All right. So in your classrooms, if you know how it works, I need to hear you. Come on. I hear like two of you. Come on. Say what? So you push your hands up. Come on. All right, Zach, I want you to think about this. I mean, most of them are eighth graders, so I want you to take them back, you know, just like a couple of years, maybe like even the sixth grade, the fifth grade. You remember some of them songs? So, Zach, that's your challenge. I want to see if you can find some songs that they forgot about. So we'll keep working on that. Zero next up from Edison Middle School. Shout out, Edison. This is called Whispers. This is Tessa Blum.
Whispers fly around the room like a game of telephone. Annie, I heard she cries in the bathroom every day. I heard both her parents left because of her. I heard. It's an endless chain of assumptions, holding the lies and deceptions that have been created. By who? No way to know. Could be no one and everyone at once. It's very contagious, a virus that spreads from person to person. Information travels until it reaches its intended destination. Within a matter of minutes, everybody knows. Once the train has started, it won't stop until it gets to the station. That stop is the next rumor started. Soon everyone forgets about Annie and moves on to the next victim. Whispers, engulfed in whispers that put others down. Drown out the voices that need to be heard. Don't say a word to defend, it will never end. What if those whispers turn into shouts, loud accusations, assumptions about people who weren't deserving? It's very unnerving, you see, those whispers. But what if the whispers can't win? We could quiet the din of the lies, those shouts, drown them out, know the truth, be honest, stop the whispers. All it takes is one person, don't pass it on. If you don't say anything, the rumor won't spread, it will be dead. That one person stopped it before the sickness became deadly. Soon one person becomes more, so we can shut the door on the train of those whispers. It's a team effort, you see. It will take everyone. One person can start it, but many more must join so we can forever end the toxic whispers. You don't need a vaccination or pill, just your tongue to stop the virus from spreading. Don't say a word, let others be heard to tell the real story. But sometimes the virus is sneaky, slithering like a snake around people's mouths without being recognized until it's reached its victim. Then bam, they've been hit. Nobody saw it coming. So think about what you're saying. Recognize your words as helpful or hurtful. Like the old saying says, if you haven't got anything nice to say, don't say anything at all. Imagine what would happen if we abided by those rules. Be kind. Stop the whispers before they start. The cruel words would be drowned out, the virus contagious, no more. We'd shut the door on the train of those whispers.
All right, we're gonna find a little competition with our crowd here. Crowd, this is participation, all right? This is like a scavenger hunt. Here's the deal, I'm gonna find out who's in here. So we wanna figure out who's got the furthest, so from Axtell Park right here in Sioux Falls, who's the furthest person from here? So I wanna see a driver's license from like the furthest spot from right here. Who's got it in here? Come on, somebody. Somebody got a far driver's license from here? Somewhere other than Sioux Falls? In our crowd, what's up? Come on. Don't worry, I won't make you dance. I'll make you dance if you don't do it. I know they don't have a license. Well, some of them might. You live in Minnesota for real or where you're at? Beaver Creek, Minnesota. Anybody beat Beaver Creek, Minnesota? Little tiny town. So, where are you from? Oh, wow. What's your name in the back? Miss White is, she lives in Mitchell. So that's gonna be Beaver Creek. We got somebody from Minnesota, we got somebody from Mitchell coming to rock with us. Awesome, you win, Miss White. Back when I win competitions, we get Jolly Ranchers. I wish I had the Jolly Rancher for you right now. All right, here we go. Next up, she's from Patrick Henry. This is called This Is America. This is Maddie Johnson.
This is America, where cops can panic, but people must stay calm. Called to arrest the guilty, not kill the innocent. This is America, where stolen land is fair, but if your request isn't granted, it's rigged. Must benefit the white man or it's unlogical. This is America, where there is a mold. If you don't fit it, you don't fit in. The mold holds power. Others, empty-handed. This is America, where racism is justified. Defend the killer or fight for the killed. Stay quiet or scream your ideas. This is America. Time to vote. Racist or not as racist? Allegations swept away. Money equals power. So their flaws are okay? This is America. I'm like a rain job trying to put out a wildfire. Speak for the speechless, fight for the unfought for, use your privilege, abolish hate. This is America. Liberty and justice for all. Right, hand over your heart, repeat the lies, believe it's true or go. Because this is America, where kneeling is unpatriotic, storming the Capitol is US pride. Confederate flag is history, but slavery is the past. Racism embedded in the soil. On it we built an empire, but buildings can only be so tall before they fall over. I was raised to be proud. Land of opportunity. Come here and be free. Come here, be shown bias. Derek Chauvin was arrested. Everyone joining in praise. Only an inch to justice. Why did it take 331 days? One step forward, two steps back. Micaiah Bryant was 16. When a cop kills someone, it's self-defense. When a black girl tries to defend herself, she's a murderer. This is America, built on inequality, torn down by pride. Thrives on silence, breaks with noise. This is America, impossible to erase the past. Pick up the pencil, draw your ideas, and fight to fill them with color.
All right, Zach, here's what I'm thinking. Now, we need a blast from the past. I just want to hear, like, you got some songs, some throwbacks. I just want to know if they know them. Eighth graders, what's up? You remember this one? Help us out. You know it. Wherever you're at, stand up. Come on. How's it going? Come on. Count it down, let's go.
Five, four, three, two, one.
Everyone's been talking, revving up. All right, that was good, Zach. Thanks for taking us back. That was nice. We're going to bring out some other girls, Zach, too. But next up, this is called No More Silence. She's from Memorial Middle School. Here to rock it for you. This is Jada Glover.
My mom used to put bows and ribbons in my hair. Braids with daunting patterns and designs that made all the other girls stare. But I had no idea that my hair, my braids, were unprofessional in the workplace and undesirable to the world. To fit their beautiful, I straightened my hair. I could straighten my hair 1,000 times, no matter what I do, I will always be different. The only black person in the room, the only person with my hair, the only person who cares if you say the N-word or not, standing in a room of people who don't look like me. You can never understand the loneliness that comes with it. They stand there with their privilege, the privilege of knowing where they come from, the privilege of never being scared, and the privilege of deciding how society sees you. Still. Don't say anything. Don't say anything. Unless you want a boy to walk behind you thinking it's funny to call people racist, am I a joke to you? The color of my skin is the only reason they do it, hoping to get the black girl mad. Well, I am mad. I'm mad at the man who called me a slave when I was 10. I'm mad at the girls who used to pick on me in first grade, calling me monkey and ape. I'm mad that I never had a doll that looked like me. And I'm mad at the world for making a little girl feel so alone. Black Lives Matter, it's not a trend, it's not a moment, it's a movement. It's my life, it's all of our lives. My life matters. Don't you think my life matters? This system is broken. Even though I'm free, I still feel trapped. Trapped by the stereotypes, trapped by the manager following me around in the store, glaring over my shoulder as if I'm already guilty of something. Innocent until proven guilty. No, guilty until proven innocent. Trapped by the backhanded compliments. People coming to me saying, oh, I love your hair. You look so, I'm sorry, exotic. Oh my gosh, Jada, you're not like other black people, you're different. It's okay, I love you. Oh my gosh, go queen, yes. Touching, pulling, pushing my hair. If I'm some animal at a show house ready to be auctioned off to the wealthiest buyer, I have been silenced for too long. We have been silenced for too long. Scared of fitting the stereotypes of an aggressive black woman, I will no longer be controlled by others' disapproval of me. I stand here full aware of the fact my words won't leave this room for fear of them. But I'm done being scared, and I'm done hiding behind silence. Say everything, say everything, say it all. Who cares after all?
Can't show me there's no point in trying. I'm at one, and I've been quiet for so long. I found peace in your violence. Can't show me there's no point in trying. I'm at one, and I've been silent for so long.
That you're not just hearing today, I hope that you're really listening, because the cool thing about some of this art is it takes us places, and some of them that might be uncomfortable for some of us, but we get to learn something, we get to really listen, and there's a difference from just hearing something, but listening is like listening deep within. So we'll invite you to keep doing that. You guys are doing awesome. We're going to keep letting you jump up, dance around, talk, whatever in between, and then we definitely want to keep bringing you back, because we want to be good listeners. So next up, this topic, this one's called Rape. She's from Whittier. This is Samanda Jamal, everybody.
Rape. When people hear that word, most people blame the victim. 97% are women, and I'm not saying men don't. It happens before the age of 18. People blame the clothing, saying she was wearing this or that. I don't blame the clothing. A 3-month-old guy raped our own father. What the hell was she wearing that was so sexy or hot? Why should I have to be scared to walk alone at night? And I'm not the only one that feels that way. I shouldn't have to feel that way. Men, people make so many excuses for men, saying he's just a boy, that's just how he acts. But he can rape a 5-year-old? A 33-year-old woman got raped by a police officer. By the one person I should feel safe calling, I don't. I don't know if I would get hurt. By the one person I should feel safe calling. I have to fear for my life. I have to question myself if people are gonna believe me when I tell them that I was raped from a young age. I was told I can't wear short skirts because boys are here. I was told if I was raped or sexually assaulted, it is my fault. I was told I can't wear that. So I sit in my room, crying myself to sleep because nobody listens to me. I have thoughts of suicide in my head. I am scared for my life. So when you rape a little girl, you have scarred her for life. So don't make any excuses for boys, and I say boys because if you're men, you would know not to rape girls or a woman.
What's wrong with the world, mama? People living like they ain't got no mamas. I think the whole world's addicted to the drama. Only attracted to things that'll bring the trauma. Overseas, yeah, we trying to stop terrorism, but we still got terrorists here living in the USA, the big CIA, the Bloods and the Crips and the KKK. But if you only have love for your own race, then you only leave
leave space to discriminate. And to discriminate only generates hate. And when you hate, then you're bound to get irate. Yeah, madness is what you demonstrate. And that's exactly how anger works and operates. Man, you gotta have love just to set it straight. Take control of your mind and meditate. Let your soul gravitate.
Let's see the hearts like this, y'all. Where's the love?
Children hurt and you hear them crying. Can you practice what you preach? And won't you turn the other cheek? Father, Father, Father.
Can we make some noise for our DJ? Zio, thanks for getting us going, Zach. And just so you know, after this next one, I'm gonna have everybody stand up. That's like pretty much our intermission. So we're gonna find out who the best dancer in here is, what we're gonna do. In the classroom too. So don't act surprised, cause it's coming. So next up, this is called Two Worlds. She's from George McGovern. Please welcome Tiana Randall.
I am mixed. Two worlds and cultures colliding together to create a girl who will only be seen as one color, a pigment, that only rebirths the figment of their imagination as to what I will be and who I will become. This sigh did not come from greatness in some of their eyes. I am descended from a man who lived to spend more time out on the streets with his fleet instead of with his children while they learned to place their tiny feet on the world for the very first time. His hair thick with small curls that circle his brain and his dark skin and scars that show the history of his people's pain. I am descended from a woman seen as an angel, golden hair compared to the sun and eyes as blue and deep as the Atlantic. A woman who chose to cope with her flaws by constantly getting into foolish antics. And although she is my mother and I love her with all my heart, don't think for a second, please, that she wasn't just as naive as those who choose to ignore one of the biggest problems in this country. As much as she tried to protect me from the world of black and white, wrong and right, fight or flight, hiding me in her womb for 9 months, she realized the fact, the color of her baby's skin makes her a target. She and I both know that she is white, seen from the heights of that snowy privileged mountain, knowing that her baby girl will never get to reach that quite yet. That she will be hanging on to that rope that separates that very mountain and the dumps below filled to the brim with oppression, with her dear life. And some of you will never know the fear of that oppression. Being thrown into those dumps and hidden from those history books, constantly hearing about the hundreds getting their lives taken every day due to their looks. You will never know the anger of finding out a man who is supposed to protect you puts a bullet to your chest and a knee on your neck. And until you are in my skin, let it soak in. All the facts and evidence that is placed in front of you every day, every night, every month, and every year, that you have not a clue to our kind of fear. Fear. Is that what it is? Is that where you create a whole world, a whole new way of life that views us as a threat? Do you fear our skin that your God gave us to wear? Do you fear our hair that seems to make a statement when entering a room anywhere? Or maybe our voices that seem to make those soulful tunes and those perfectly imperfect blues? You may hate us and fear us as much as you want, go crazy as a mad hatter trying to make us disappear, but we're proud to say that we're all still standing here, and we are climbing up that equality ladder, while putting that fact in your head on the way, that black lives will always matter. Thank you.
I told you guys I need you up out your seat. Come on, come on. Wherever you're at in your classroom, the best dancer. We got to see him. If you got some moves in here, it's time to go. Come on. Who's the best dancer in here? And if you don't know how to dance, just kind of do this thing. Hey. I think the little one right in the middle, I think that might be our best dancer. Hey. She's got it. You wanna come up here? You wanna come? Yeah, okay. You got some dance moves? Will you dance with us? Well, let's dance right here, come on. What's your name? Let's go, come on, you got some moves, let's go! Isn't she so cute, y'all? Come on! Thank you. you for coming up here. You can go right back down there. Awesome. All right, I hope you have an answer in your classroom out there. Thank you. All right, we like to have fun. That's how this poetry slam works, so you can kind of wiggle yourself right back down. I try to keep you live, you know, so we got a few more, and I want to keep the energy up for the rest of our people. We want to be great listeners, but we also want to give them some energy in the room, too. So next up from Edison Middle School, she's going to talk on stereotypes. This is called Stereotypes. This is Katya Surendran.
Stereotypes. They're the volcanoes that stay in one's mind, usually dormant on the surface, but bubbling and festering on the inside. They erupt out of one's mind, spreading the unfair and unjust opinions, spewing the hot and fiery hatred onto someone who did nothing but exist. Stereotypes are the plague of biases kept in the corners of one's mind until they step into the spotlight. They are the plague passed down from generation to generation. They are the plague that works its way through the minds and the mouths they spread to everyone. Everyone is the unfortunate victim. I hear I'm Asian, which makes me smarter. I hear I'm a cancer, which makes me sensitive. I hear I look different, so I must be different. I must be from elsewhere. I must speak another language. I must have strict immigrant parents. I must. Apparently, my appearance from my head to my shoes tells you all of my political views. Apparently, my race tells you all of my traits. Apparently, my nationality can tell you my personality. Apparently, all that I am is exactly how I look. But that's just not the case. It's just not true. I'm not a stereotype. I don't fit in with your view. Don't make your plague victimize me. Don't make your hot and bubbling magma burn my skin. Don't make your words sticks and stones. Because if you had bothered to look past the surface, seen past my race, seen past my skin color, talked to me instead of stalked me, I would have told you who I am. I would have told you that my first name is Russian. I would have told you that my mom lived in India and my dad lived in Zambia. I would have told you that my mom tried to teach me her foreign tongue, but every time she spoke, I'd run. I would have told you that all I've ever known and all I ever was is right here in the United States of America. I would have told you my whole life story. Because if you had seen past my skin color, you would have seen that I wear no armor. If you had seen past my race, you would have seen my true face. If you had seen past your beliefs, you would have seen that I wear my heart on my sleeve. If only you had asked instead of assumed, my skinniness, my shortness, my ethnicity are all on the surface. If only you had looked past it to see me, because all that I am is not how I look. My appearance tells you nothing, how I look doesn't mean anything. You don't know what it's like to see through my perspective. You don't know what it's like in my shoes because they don't fit you. You don't know me, and I don't know you. So I beg you, the next time you meet a person, the next time you see a stranger, the next time you think you know someone, don't judge and don't assume because you don't know the whole story.
Oh, oh. All right, Zach, that's a throwback. Oh, oh. If you know this one, you gotta sing it out. Come on, come on. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, bass coming next. Don't worry. Let's sing it out, come on. I know you care. She said, somebody in the audience just goes, no. If you know it, sing it like you really mean it. Come on, come on. We will never, ever, ever be apart. Are we an item? Girl, quit playing. We're just friends. What are you saying? Said there's another in the right. Let's go, let's go. Sing it out. You got it, Maddie. You got it. All right, Zio. There's been a request for some bae. This is a challenge. It's a challenge. You got to read her mind. All right, next up. This is called Beneath the Moonlight from Patrick Henry. Please welcome Charlie Larson, everyone.
Beneath the moonlight lies a house, surrounded in darkness, only a speckle of light to be seen. A table lamp illuminates an empty framed man, scribbling on a piece of paper hoping to find some sense of worth, wanting to fill his vacant stature with a picture so bright and vivid. The fuel to his flame is his desire to stand above the rest, to look down on others, seeing the hairs in their heads covering their ugly scalps, to have a voice pretty hard, but a king who dominates his people. Aware of his selfish desire, he hides himself, puts on a mask that covers more than these small pieces of cloth ever will. His cover is the speech that comes out of his mouth, but his actions have words of their own. He is an abandoned ship, drifting away from the help of other sailors, doomed to be stranded in the middle of the Pacific, destined to join the black hole of trash that floats atop the water. You would think that someone so aware of his own fate would at least try to avoid it. This man does not. So long as he is the greatest piece of trash in the sea, he will be appeased. How could someone be like this? How could someone be devoured by such a greedy craving? Beneath the moonlight lies a house, surrounded in darkness, only a speckle of light to be seen. A table lamp illuminates an empty framed man, scribbling on a piece of paper, hoping to find some sense of worth. His flame was fueled by people around him, telling him to be the leader, ridiculing him for trying his best, pushing him to be better. Not a gentle, supportive push, a shove, focused forward into a fiery furnace that cursed him to be baked alive, reducing his confidence in the ashes that blow in the wind, traveling so far. With no clear destination. What is the man writing? He is writing his will, granting his entire life to his craft. The paper is a vacuum, sucking up all the useless dirt and its trash until the man is enveloped in obsession, imprisoned by passion, polluted by perfection. Everything around him serves as a constant reminder. You keep messing up, says the overflowing trash can of crumpled up papers, reaching higher than the peak of Everest. You need to be better, say the broken pencils littered across the desk, reminders of every time he failed. Good job, say the people in his life, unaware of the gun they have just fired.
Thanks, Charlie. You got some other throwbacks on there? What else are you feeling? Here's what we're going to do. We're going to try something a little different. Just to spice it up, we're kind of on the finale here. We're getting towards the end of our poems. We're going to do a little, like, rock, paper, scissors competition, okay? So next time I come back up here, I'm going to have you look at a person next to you. You're going to have to find somebody. And then it goes rock, paper, scissors, shoot. And if you win, then you advance, okay? So you'll advance to the next time. But if you lose, then you're out. So you gotta be honest with it, and this is how it works. You say, rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Okay, so sometimes you can go back to back. Like, I can't see Zach right now. Zach, turn that way. Are you ready? Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Oh, what? Come on, do it again. Rock,
paper, scissors, shoot.
Oh, they're brothers. Ready? Rock,
paper, scissors, shoot.
Three.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Paper.
Hey! I couldn't do it with the microphone, Zach. That's 1-0 if you're keeping track. So Zach would be out, and then I'd advance to the next round. That's how we're going to do it, okay? So stay tuned, coming up, and then we'll just keep doing it around. So you'll play one person, they'll be eliminated, and we'll keep going. So next up from Memorial Middle School, this is Neshemwe Esta. Do you see me like I see you? Let's welcome Neshemwe.
They put a gun to my head saying, don't move or I'll shoot. I stand there as still as a rock, not saying a word, not moving a muscle. I hear desperation in my mom, frustration in my dad. I stand there, cuffs on my arms, smile on my face, mouthing the words, I'll be okay. In reality, I'm frightened. In reality, I'm fearful for my life. In reality, my heart's beating at 100 miles per second. Yet I still have the courage to smile. I stand there proud, knowing I'm innocent. I know I've done no wrong. I know children look up to me. Yet, I stand there, cuffs on my arms, still standing, as still as a rock. I remember these key words that my mom had once told me. Never say a word. Never look them in the eye. Show no fear. Why would an 8-year-old kid like me remember such words? Why would an 8-year-old kid like me take these words to my grave? Why would an 8-year-old kid like me soon realize why my mom said these exact same words to me? She knew. She knew I could never walk down the street without getting accused of a crime. She knew one day this would happen. She knew. I, on the other hand, didn't listen. I didn't follow these simple steps. I made my mom disappoint in me. I made the biggest mistake of my life. I decided to look. I decided to speak. I decided to show fear. But I know the difference between right and wrong. What they were doing was wrong. They took my rights. They took my freedom. They took my joy. This is the land of the free. Why am I looked at differently? Why am I considered a criminal? Why am I considered a ghetto? When I'm just like you, just a different color. I am not brown, I am not yellow, and I sure ain't white. I am black, I am proud to be black. I am proud of my Afro hair, I am proud of my big lips, I am proud of my black skin. There is nothing wrong for being different. There is nothing wrong for being yourself. There is nothing wrong for me being me. When will this world start accepting my race? When will this world start treating me with respect? When will this world see my race as their equal? Did Martin Luther King, Rosa Parks, Harriet Tubman sacrifice their life for nothing? Did George Washington and Abraham Lincoln leave this world just for it to see the same way they left it? I want to ask Gen Z, when will you make your mark on our historic timeline? When will you finally speak up?
All right, you know what to do now. So in your classrooms, it's easier if you stand up for sure. Find a partner next to you. Even if you're sitting down, you can look at the person next to you, just kind of tilt your shoulder. And then as soon as you're ready, it goes rock, paper, scissors, shoot. You should be doing it right now, wherever you're at. This is just first round, one person, find one person. It's best out of one unless you tie like me and Zach. So in your classrooms, you should know right now, there might be a couple more like rounds. But if you won, you advance to the next round. If you lose, you sit down and you cheer for the person next to you, all right? All right, you guys, we got one more from every school. One more from every school. So keep rocking with us. We have some people advanced in our rock, paper, scissors competition. This one's called Baby Doll Cut. She's from Whittier Middle School. This is Grace Surratt.
Girl over there who you've picked on ever since second grade. Well, she has family issues. And you, do you see that guy over there who you've pushed down the stairs how many times now? Well, his father just died. You smile and laugh. For what? Girls come home crying into their mother's arms. Baby, don't cut. People are getting kicked down in these streets. Baby, don't cut, please. Her parents just got a divorce. Baby, don't cut. It's not your fault. Her own best friend just stabbed her in the back. Baby, don't cut. You smile and laugh as boys and girls play tic-tac-toe on their wrists. Over 100,000 people died of suicide per year. One every 40 seconds. Baby, don't cut. When I grow old and have children of my own, they're going to ask, Mama, why do you have scars? Do you fight in a war? And I'll say, Yes, a very long and cold war, but I won. And promise me this, baby. Don't cut. Thank you.
We need some honesty, so if you lost, you gotta cheer, but if you won, you gotta find somebody who won, okay? Find, even in here, but in for sure in the classroom. The classroom should have about 15 people still going, so find somebody right away. Remember, it's best out of one. You don't have to wait for me to go. It's rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Go back to back, and it's the honesty code. I'm not there to judge the room. Be honest, don't cheat. If you win, you win. If you won, you're still rocking. Remember, just do one game, and if there's somebody left over who couldn't be a part of it, like one extra person, then I don't know, either they find somebody or else they advance. That's how that works. They don't lose though. All right, cool. So now we should be down to about 8 or so left in a room, all right? So next up, from George McGovern, this is called I Hate, and this is Gearson Arevalo.
I Hate. Hope you like it. Where can I start? Of all the things I hate. But here we go. Of all the dumb things I hate. I hate how people hate each other. I see it every day with these classmates. I hate you, I hate you more, I wish you would die. Man, I hear it every day, those are things, everyday things. I hate how we have to lose people. Kobe Bryant, what a legend. But I'm sorry, I cried too, we lost him in seconds. But we must move on. Oh, but I can't forget how good of a dad he was. He was a role model to me. Everything related to basketball, he said, never give up. I would never give up. He said, work harder. I would work harder. Every single time he told me not to give up, I would never give up. You know, life is not a race. Your life can end in seconds. I don't know why my life is going in milliseconds. I could be dead right now for all I know. Oh, wait. Am I in a dream? I don't know, wake up. I don't know, am I a theme? I don't know, do people take me as a meme? I don't know, I hate that I can't tell. I hate that I have to act like someone in front of people. I just wanna be myself. I don't wanna pretend to, I'm tired of putting this fake face on. I don't know why my phone just has a plain case. Man, life is not a race. You just gotta go at a steady pace. Life makes you feel so good. It makes you feel in love. Love made me get a girlfriend. But look, love can make you feel so good someday, and then the other day it makes you feel like a piece of trash that they stomp on and tell you nothing. So love does, makes you feel good, and then makes you feel bad. No, that's the whole reason why I like the word love. It made me feel good by myself. Made me feel buff, made me feel all good and that. But then it made me feel like a piece of trash that they just stomp on and they smear on the ground and tell you nothing. Talking too much like always. I've always talked too much. I'm gonna go to sleep. Gosh dang it, why can't I go to sleep, man? There's so much heat in my room. I just wanna open the door. I just wanna open the window. I just wanna get out. I just wanna say my prayer, but I can't. I don't know why, it's dark. I just wanna wake up into a good reality. I just wanna wake up to me being one of the best drummers, but just drumming took 10 years. I don't think I'm gonna be the best in 20 years. Hold on, wait a minute. My mind's saying one thing and my mind's saying the other. I just wanna be someone who is great, who can change the world, who can inspire. But then the other side of me is saying you can't inspire, but I know it's the devil. You know, every day I look at myself and I say, you're gonna be great. Okay, I'm done now.
Thanks, Gerson. All right, Zach, we should have like 8 in our rock, paper, scissors competition. We should have 8 left. So if you're still up, you need to be up. There should be about 8. So if there's less, if there's like 4 still remaining in your classroom, 4 advance to the next round. But if there's 8, I need 8 people. So if you're still in, you gotta find somebody. Or if that means you're out, you're still in? Let's go. All right, so at the end of this, there should be four left in your room. Four left in your room. How many, who do I got left in here? I got four people, at least, or do you all disqualify each other? One person, you're the champ already? I love it. You're just gonna give her the championship, just like that. Okay, there should be four people left. Next round, we're doing it. We got just a few more for you here. This one is called This Is a Shame Story from Edison Middle School. This is Hudson Weber.
Shame, guilt, insecurity. I've struggled my entire life. From 5 to 14, it's been a part of me. You see, my shame is mountain. Overwhelming, tiring, too much to handle. And my guilt is a shadow over me. Never goes away, always coming back the next day. And my insecurity is a dark abyss. Impossible to escape from, makes me feel numb. Problem is, I try to be perfect, intent to detect every outcome, but can't stop what's to come. So I have 1 million things to process, every single screw up, every single mistake. It runs through my head, keeps me up at night. What could have been said, done, tried. Little things are magnified, make me not satisfied. I want to feel dignified, I want to feel classified, but I can't with this problem of mine. In the end, things seem hopeless. I'm at the point where I'm helpless. I beat myself up, told myself I'm not enough. It feels as if I'm stuck. Stuck in the muck, waiting and waiting because I need someone to pull me up. Someone to pull me out of my crap, my brokenness, my pain, my shame, guilt, and insecurity. But luckily for me, there is hope. Because when I'm on my knees, desperate in need, God pulls me out of the mud and he says, you are loved, son. You are inspiring. You are a blessing. You are hope to the future. You are brave. You are a miraculous gift. So what do you take away from this? Well, don't judge someone from what's on the outside. Because buried in all the skin, this joy and success I try to wear, there is a shame story. Thank you.
Thanks, Hudson. All right, in your classroom, you should have four people left. You should have four left. If you have four, stand up right now, find a partner. Here's the only difference. We're doing best two out of three. Best two out of three. Find your four people right now. Back to back. Yep, that's a competition. Let's go. And then next round, there'll be two left for the championship of your room. Yes, yes, there will. How's it win? Okay, you forgot that I haven't lost yet. You know what I mean? So I'm gonna see you next round. Let's go for the championship. So there should be two left now in your room. Two left in your room. And we're going to have that championship. If you need to pick two, if you don't have to, there should be two left. So are you guys left back there? All right, you two, that's the championship next round. Let's go. All right, we have two more performers for you. And then we're going to keep things going for today. Did somebody say lunch?
What?
All right, we got from Patrick Henry. This is called Too Young. This is Jacqueline Bouchard, everybody.
People say, I don't have a voice. They say, you don't get a choice. People say, I am too young, for I am not yet strong. They say that I am blind, or that I need an adult to hide behind. They say, don't worry, the adults will handle the fury. Because I am a child not yet grown, not yet spread my wings and flown. But I have a mind, and I am more than they will ever find. The older you are, the harder you hold on. Hold on to the ways that have been around for too long. I have a vision of the world I want to see. So why do I have no way to say what it will be? I am the future that will hold on to this world. So why are you leaving it broken and unfurled? This mess will be left for me and the others in my century. So tell me why I have no voice. Tell me why I am too blind. Tell me why I should not worry when you leave so many behind. We are your children who must deal with your mistakes. So why are you treating our ideas like it will make this world break? But I am too young. Too young to understand, too young to make a serious stand. You say this as you throw trash in the sea and you let people act like this is anarchy. We scream and shout, but you refuse to hear. Refuse to hear what we have to fear. It is true that I may be young, but that does not make me dumb. Someday you have to let go. Someday you have to let us grow.
Way to go, Jacqueline. All right, finalists, we need you right in the middle of this walkway, right over here, come on. This is best two out of three, right in the middle, come on. This is best two out of three now. So get back to back. Yes, perfect, back to back. In your classrooms, back to back. Ready. You don't have to wait for me. It's rock, paper, scissors, go. Say it. All right, that's a tie. Keep going. Let's go. In your room. That's 1-0. That's 1-0. Remember, it's 2 out of 3. That's 1-1 in here. That's 1-1, right? That was 2-0. That was a sweep. That's a championship. What's up? Yes, awesome. That's our champ in the back. And you should have a champ in your room. Congratulations. I wish we could like bring you all like here and that'd be awesome. But congratulations on your Rock, Paper, Scissors Championship. We've got one more performer, and I love that he's talking about chicken nuggets. What? He's talking about chicken nuggets, y'all. This is Evan Gullickson. He's from Memorial Middle School. To bring it home for us, let's hear it for Evan.
It's chicken tenders.
Oh, thanks, man.
All right. Chicken tenders make me tender. A fierce contender, the food wars ender. Nothing will ever compete with the exquisite golden brown. The savory, juicy flavor is by far the best around. Savor in every bite, crisp in every crunch. There's nothing more I'd want to eat for breakfast, dinner, or lunch. I want chicken tendies, Popeyes, Chick-fil-A, or Wendy's. Please gimme my own chicken tendies. Some vegans will say it's murder. I'm an abominable human being. But with such a scrumptious taste, it's clear they were created to be eaten. Sometimes I do feel guilty when I consider how my meal was born to be slaughtered. But as soon as I consume the pristine pieces of meat, I can no longer be bothered. Tendies are my heart's desire, fueled by raging hungry fire. Tendies are there to fill the hole that I feel within my soul. Yes, I may be obsessed, that's something I can't deny, but how can anybody resist something so masterfully fried? In fact, I'm more than obsessed. I'm addicted, vitally dependent. It's more than just a favorite food, you see, because chicken tenders are my ecstasy. My friends confronted me, and they said, this is an intervention. We've noticed changes in you that need to be brought to attention. You're gaining weight, you cut us off, and you haven't been yourself. Lay off the chicken tenders. Trust us, we're here to help. But I became enraged and I spat back, tendies are my vitality, and the fact you're trying to cut me off from them is nothing short of a fallacy. I sprinted away as fast as possible, consumed with hatred and betrayal. I thought that I could trust my friends, but never expected them to be so disgraceful. Then, once I'm alone, I begin to break down and curl up on the floor, my head and my knees sobbing. I need chicken tendies. I need chicken tendies. Please. Without them, I am meaningless. In that moment, my soul was shattered. I was cold, alone, afraid, and shaking. I'm a broken man, left hollow and empty, corrupted by my love for chicken tendies.
So you're still thinking of me, just like I know you should. I cannot give you everything you know I wish I could. I'm so high at the moment, I'm so caught up in this. You're just a young, dumb, and broke, but we still got love to give. Are we young, dumb, young, dumb, and broke? Young, dumb, young, young, dumb, and broke. Young, dumb, young, young, dumb, and broke. Young, dumb, broke, high school, high
school. All right, we need all our finalists to the front of the stage. All our 20 finalists. Evan, I want to apologize for calling the attendees nuggets. That was on me. Should have never done that. They're tenders. All right, come on, finalists in the spot. Let's hear it for all 20 of the finalists. Yes, yes, up on your feet, let's go! So we want to take a... Alright, so I know some of you just met, it's okay. But I want you to squeeze in as much as we can. We want to take a picture with you. Maybe we could put like... Yeah, let's squeeze down just a little bit, squeeze down. Or yeah, you could spread out just a little bit. Yeah, that would look cool. Hey, let's all like, let's use the top three rows, okay? So come down. All right, come in, squeeze in. We got one more row. All right, guys, we're taking three pictures, okay? First one, it's up to you. First one, look good. Second one, hands up. Third one, like, get weird, okay? All right, first one, looking good, smiling. Look at the crowd, let's go. Everybody smile. Okay, second one, hands up. What? 2021 Poetry Slam finalist! Alright, this last one, like I need people to get, like sit down, like get cozy, do something weird, what's up? 2021 finalists, squeeze in! Alright, ready? Guys, everybody, 3, 2, 1, let's go! Yeah, let's hear it from these guys up here, come on! Okay, stay up front, get cozy. I want you to give a shout out to my friend in the back. You guys don't even see him, but he's a magician. He's the one who made it capable for me to be like right here, but yet in the school. His name's Ben in the back. Say what's up, Ben, everybody. Thank you for serving us today, Ben. There are a bunch of people in the back who've been helping us keep things moving, so shout out to them real quick. Me and Zach are so pumped to come do this every year. It's one of our favorite things. Like about 8 years ago or something, they're like, hey, you guys should come help us out. And I actually love it. I want to tell you why. I love it because of you guys, because of what it represents. I love how you find your voice and you find your story and you share it. And that is so, so powerful. But my hope is that you don't just do it today. And if you're watching online or if you weren't in the top five, it doesn't matter. It's about art helps people find their voice and find their story. And what when you start sharing yours, it impacts other people. So keep doing that. Keep finding creative ways, whether it's music or writing or art. If it's just for you, do it just for you. But the cool part is, when you do it and you share it, you have no idea what somebody's going through, and they might have needed what you said, and you used your words so powerfully. So I want to say that to you. And as a team here, we just want to say, literally, thank you guys for being up here, for sharing this, for doing this. Yes. Yes, yes. All right, this is a little different. I need your hands like this. I'm gonna say 1, 2, 3, and we're gonna clap and push. It's like one thing at the same time. It's like this. Okay, and it's just a blessing. It says keep going, and it says keep growing. Don't stop growing, because that's what this success is as you keep growing, as you keep figuring out your voice and your story, we're just saying keep going, keep growing. And then when they clap it, I want y'all to just like let it hit you. Okay, because that, right, okay? If you, Garrison, I know you're about ready. Come down here, because you're going to fall. Come on, Garrison, right here. You got space to fall. You got space to fall. All right, fine. Dope. Hey, it's all good. Ready, y'all ready? Hands ready. Every good thing to these guys. Keep going. Keep growing. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Let it hit. All right, cool.
Yep.
Okay, thank you. Okay, perfect, perfect. All right, so here's the deal. On my sheet here, I want to shout out that we picked some winners, but you guys, seriously, like, we have a gift card for every one of you, and we want you to know that you already, like, kicked butt. You stood up here, you did this, so awesome. We did some judging, we picked some winners, which is cool, but I want you to know already that you guys are our champions for us, so. Here's a couple names for you that we want to shout out. From each school, we have a champion, and I want to give that name right here. From George McGovern Middle School, our champion from George McGovern is Tiana Randall, everybody. What's up, Tiana? Middle School. Please, let's hear for our champion of Patrick Henry, Maddie Johnson. From Edison Middle School, our champion from Edison is Katya Sarandon. Thank you, Katya. From Whittier, please make some noise for Grace Surratt. From Memorial, his wasn't called Nuggets, it was Tenders. Evan Grossen, everybody. And our grand champion for the 2021 Sioux Falls School District Poetry Slam. I need you guys to make some noise from Patrick Henry, Jacqueline Bouchard. So we have a Sioux team. Yes, come on, let's see if we're all 20. A certificate and gift card for all of you, so we want you to make sure they're going to bring them out to you. Thank you so much. Let's hear it one more time for our contestants up here. This is CEO. I'm Adam. We're from PJ Seesaw. Thank you guys for having us. Anything else we got to say before we go? Thank you for being here. Yes, come see Heidi if you haven't got your certificate. Online, peace out in the school. We'll see y'all soon. All the best. Thank you for a wonderful day. And hopefully this art moves you to find your art and go and make an impact and make the world a better place, y'all. Thank you so much. See you next time. Contestants, take a bow. Come on. You killed it. Deep breath. You did it. You did it. Evan, if I would have known, I would have got a sponsorship for chicken tenders. We should have. We should just have chicken tenders for everybody. Yeah. You get a chicken tender. You get a chicken tender. You get a chicken tender. I'm like the veteran. I've been doing all 10 of them with Zio over here. 10 years, Zach, can you believe that? That's so awesome. Thank you guys for finding out that bit of fact. Peace out, y'all. Thank you, eighth graders. Congratulations.